Hey everyone, I just decided to add a cat, a Cheshire cat onto this. I forgot to show you how I put this on here. I just hand traced it off of a picture that I printed off of Google. So I'm just kind of, I want an outline, but I want it to look kind of creepy. I'm just kind of blending everything in right now. You can kind of see it coming together a little bit. But I also want it to be creepy because he's kind of creepy, so. I want you to just kind of be able to see his features up close. Because like I said, I kind of want him in the background, just being creepy. So I'm just kind of doing his front leg right now. But I want his eyes to be super green, I think, so that they stick out really well. So you can kind of see his face shape a little better. Kind of shape his body a little better too. I don't really care too much about showing his feet because he's on the branch. It's kind of like he's sitting on top of everything, you know, like when cats sit. I will do his front paws, but I'm not going to worry about his hind leg. Which, actually, that was pretty poor. Where did they go? Let's grab this and kind of just wipe it away a little bit. I just want to clean the line up. That's better. That brush is not doing it though. Can't zoom in either. Let me see. Sorry, I'm just gonna move in a little closer. I might, he's what, purple and pink. So I've kind of accented and highlighted his shape with my light pink. Now I'm gonna go in and I probably will do some stripes with my amethyst, which is that purple color, and plum crazy. It's a kind of a darker room color. I feel like maybe if I turn the light for this off, is that better? I don't know. Let's leave it on. I really can't tell, honestly. Okay. I'm gonna grab this square brush I was using and use that for my pink, and then I'll grab another brush, like this little dome brush, for my purple. I'm gonna clean this off though, this brush. I don't think I have another square brush right here, but that's okay. I want this to be very faded, so I'm gonna take off most of it. And I'm going to spray my cat, and I'm going to start just kind of, that's it. Maybe a little more. Nothing crazy. I'm spraying too much water. It's starting to run a little bit. I'm gonna not do that, but I can help it. I don't know if his face is striped or not, honestly, in the old movie. Super careful on the tail. You don't want it to look choppy. Make sure you go edge to edge. Okay, so there's that. And now we'll go in and do the same thing with the purple. I'm gonna add, actually I'm not gonna do anything else. Well, I am gonna make a nose with the pink. But I'm not gonna do anything else to his face, I don't think, because I really want that the eyes and the mouth to stand out, because I just think it's so creepy. So, go in there and get that. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna kind of let this dry. And I'll go back in with my black and kind of. Now that I have my colors on, I can go back in and kind of do more edging around the black of the black. Here's my black brush, because I don't have one. I'm gonna do it really carefully too. there's that. Okay, I have a container without... No, I used the long cover. That's why. Okay. That's good. All right, let's see. Actually, I want to do his nose so that I can properly place the eyes and mouth. If I can. Oh, actually, you know what? There we go. I'm actually going to do his nose with my light pink, that color that I had. Maybe I will go back in and make his stripes a little more, or maybe I'll add like metallics to them or something. Just kind of brighten them up a little bit. There's that. Now I want his mouth very wide and white and pointy teeth. I'm gonna do this very carefully. There. Now I'm gonna go grab a green and do his eyes. So I am gonna use my white to kind of, I've got a black base, so I've gotta kind of be careful. With my shape. I'm grabbing green. I have Dixie Belle evergreen here. I think this will be a really good green. Let me see. I gotta kinda. So I'm gonna. A cat's eye is almost like a. Like it's got like the black almond pupil shape and then kind of the color on the sides. Actually, that's not the smallest brush I have. Take a super small artist brush. This. I'm gonna kind of ballpark where I think his pupils will be. Start small and then go from there. Now I'm going to take this brush that I just used, and I'm going to add some black just to kind of shape them out a little bit. I feel like I want to work on his face a little more. I feel like it's too dark for the rest of his body. So I'm just gonna dry this really quick. Do you want to kind of darken his stripes a little bit too? So there's the purple. I don't know, I might take some white around the edge too. I don't know. Where's my pink? Right there. Brush this off. Get my light pink, my peony. Could kind of just do that where he's like disappearing, because he does kind of go places once in a while. All right, now I really want to kind of just water this down and brush it over the face just to add a little bit more color. I didn't want to do his face, his eyes, and everything against a full pink face, so I also think his ear needs to be smaller. Okay, so I've got kind of the pink. I'm gonna go back in with my black. And I'm going to kind of go over it again, and then I'm going to let it do its thing. His ear is way too big on this side, so I'm going to see if I can kind of wipe it back and shape it out. And I'll just kind of add a big branch there. I kind of added some quirky leaves to the tree because it's quirky. The movie and the story.
Okay.
going to clean my brush off and I'm gonna add a little white, a small amount of white up through the ears and the face. And if it's too light, I will add some black over it. This is obviously hand painted. I'm not gonna like worry too much about it because I can only do so much artistically. But I do want to make it a little more like cartoonish. So I'm gonna kind of wipe off some of my I'm also gonna add that kind of those little lines between the nose and everything. I'm gonna add some lines to the face as well. Alright, so I think I'm done with the cap for now. I don't want to overdo it and overthink it. So I'm just going to kind of work on the rest. This brush is not cooperating though. Add a few more branches like out to here. I'm going to add a little bit more pink to his hands, claws. I'm almost wondering if I should just do his face in pink and then do all the details over again. Because I'm wondering, I didn't really want the boldness of that originally, but I think I kind of want it now. Because Alice is so bold. will. So I'm going to just kind of wipe this around. Let's do it. I already like this a lot better. I'm gonna add some water to my paint. It's really just clumpy today. I don't know. I think it's the details of his face, I know, will show. I mean, like, of his body. So I think it's important to be able to see his shape. Especially where he's up in this tree. Like I said, I want you to know that it's Cheshire Cat. No doubt. Not that I really thought that there would be any, but he just wasn't bold enough. Now he's going to be bold enough, for sure. So I'll keep working kind of on this, like this. So now I'll go back in with my purple and I'll do the purple over again. And then we'll do the shading and everything with the black instead of pink. What am I doing? I've got so many colors and stuff going on, it's not even good. So I'm just adding some water. Everything. So much happier with that. Now, like I said, I can go in with the black and outline, and I think that will be fine. And then I might work on his face later and kind of let this sit so I can look at it a little more. Much better. Much, much, much better. Definitely happier with that, for sure. happier with this. I'm like I said, I'm gonna do his face later. I'm not gonna do it now. I don't wanna like overstress myself. Okay, so that's it for now. Actually, we could do stripes on here. Or maybe I'll do I don't know what I'm gonna do down here. Stripes or Harlequin. Probably the same purple. But yeah, I'm gonna take a break from this for now. And like I said, I'll come back. Later on and kind of do this. Okay. I am going to start making molds, so that's probably what I'll do. You guys have seen that. I did the hot glue. I've done resin before, so I'm not going to do a video of that, but the hand painting I definitely wanted you to see. I'm glad we started over. I do think this tree limb has to come out because that cat is that big. He definitely needs more of that, more than just that branch to support himself. So I'm actually just gonna kind of draw it thicker there and blend it in here, and then I'll take it out. Okay, so there's that. I hope you guys enjoyed this. I'm glad I started over on the cat. I think he looks a lot better. So I am happy about that. So yeah, like I said, I'm gonna do a bunch of mushrooms. Do I have my mushroom mold? Yes, I do. I thought there were two size mushrooms in this mold, but there's only one. I can't remember the name of it. Vintage Garden, something like that. Something Garden, maybe. So there's the mushroom mold. I'm going to make a bunch of those, and I'll put them down here, and then I'll add some clocks with chain, actual chain, which would be super cool. Probably add, I wish I had like a teapot mold, because I would probably add one down here. So yeah, we'll see. I think if I can fill the middle happy, I'm going to put on the top, I'm going to handwrite "We're all mad here" and then epoxy it over this glitter. But we're going to see, because I still have to do at least another layer of glitter. So that is it for today, I think, maybe. I'm not sure, but I will see you guys soon. Bye.